Vermont. Good morning on day 152, coming to you from a tent site in Vermont. Got my hot coffee and I'm gonna have my couple bars of protein bars for breakfast while I'm letting Goose sleep in, and then we'll get a move on it. It's supposed to be a nice day today, so we should get at least 15 miles in. Cheers. Now I gotta get this whole mess packed up. There's the clothes I'm gonna wear on top, shoes and water bottles, and then I have to take down some stuff inside. Here we go. All right, it's 7:48. I got everything packed up. We got the goose over there. Hasn't even emerged from his slumber, although I have heard his voice. Look at how skinny this tent is. You wanna poke out and say hi, Goose?
No.
All right, I'll see you on the trail, son. Look at this pretty forest. Been hiking by myself for almost a mile. Been nice. Peaceful. Can you see? You might not be able to see, but there's running water in this mud. This is only day two of getting my new shoes. Gonna have to figure this one out, because I'm not getting my shoes wet. I did it, and my socks are still dry. My shoes are dry. This is so pretty. A little bit more mud, but this stuff isn't as bad. It's more dry. Let's see what I'm coming up to here. Mud. And a nice big field. Where is the trail though? I guess just right here. That's what I'm going with, guys. Heading towards the road that I can hear the cars. After climbing a huge mountain for the past 30 minutes, I'm taking a break and looking at the view here. Not too much of one. You can see parts, tops of the mountains. And there would have been a better one here, but there's a bunch of fog around there. Waiting for Goose to catch on. All right, here he finally comes. Final approach to the hill. For once, I'm ahead of him. So we're thinking about where we're gonna stay tonight. You know, that's one of our big decisions we have to make every day. Shelter, campsite, a hostel. Well, we're coming up to a city. Well, it's gonna be another 12 more miles, so. Called West Hartford, Vermont. And there's this couple that lets you camp in their backyard. They have water, they have a privy, but the selling feature for me is they have electricity. That's what it comes down to. Our phones need charges, and then our battery packs need charges. Now, it's only been like a day, 2 days since we were with Jeeper Man and got everything charged up, but obviously anytime you can top off your phone and your battery, that's good. So I think that's where we're going tonight. It'll make only for like, I think just about a 15 mile day, maybe 14 and a half miles. But that's the winner, I think. And I think we might be able to order a pizza or something once we get into that town. So that was a selling feature for Goose. Water break. Look how pretty. And look at this. I actually found a hook for my backpack. Downhill, yay, and a wide path. Today's actually been challenging because of all the uphills. I feel pretty inadequate on all these uphills. I still need to stop and catch my breath, often, depending on how steep and how long the uphill is. But But I swear today we've had more than normal. Even Goose has made note of that, so. There's that mower sound. There's always a mower sound in the distance. Every day. Weather feels fabulous today. Looks like I'll be coming down into a field. And here it is. I might even see the machine behind the mower. Look at that. Nice big open field on an angle. This is Vermont. There's a house way up there. Another even flat surface here. Hiking is just so much more enjoyable when we have a flat surface. But I don't know if you've heard the statistic, but hiking the entire Appalachian Trail is like climbing up and down Mount Everest 17 times. That's how many ups and downs this trail has. All right, so we need to cross this river. We're gonna both put on our Crocs. And I'm taking off the bottom of my pants because I don't want, and my socks, obviously. But there is a wire here that you can, I guess, hold to help yourself get across. I don't know if you can see the wire, but right to the left of this tree. This shouldn't be too bad, but just a pain taking off everything. Bunch of these things are stuck into all these trees in this area. Goes down here to the next tree. They got tubes going into them. I wonder if it's for maple syrup. I'm in Vermont. I don't know what kind of trees they are the best, but this is the tree that has all this, lots of tubing around here, lots of trees. Check it out. We just climbed another big mountain and we saw on the app that there was going to be a bench at the top. So we said, we're going to stop there and have lunch. So I'm making one of my dinner meals for lunch. And Goose is excited because he knows I won't be able to finish it all. And that means he'll get some of it too. Homestyle chicken and rice. It's got, it only has 740 calories. Goose had one last night that was 1,050. How you feeling, Goose?
Hungry.
And I'm letting my shirt dry off in the sun because both sides are soaking wet. We got 10 minutes to kill while our food comes to fruition. All right, that awesome lunch break is officially over. One of my more favorite lunch breaks, having a view, a bench, and a real meal. So that was a good stop. How cool. All right, there's the white blaze. See it on the bridge railing right here? Yep, we're in West Hartford, Vermont. And we're gonna stay in the back of someone's yard. We have arrived. Look at this cute freaking place. Captain Stash's on the Appalachian Mile, on the Appalachian Trail. I'm not sure if that mile marker's correct. I think we're at like 1730 something.
Yeah, maybe.
Look at this. Let's go see what's going on. All right, we talked to the owner, Captain Stash. What a nice guy. He said we can stay at the Chieftain Motel, which is his shed. And he said it fits about 3 or 4 people. Heck yeah! Oh my God, I've never slept in a shed before.
Nice and dry.
This is cool. Yeah, it's raining, so, oh my God, I'm so super excited. I am super excited. All right, guys, look what Goose acquired for us. Man. All right, Goose, you want to do the opening up?
The honors.
The honors. We're eating in the shed.